Welcome. In this video, we're going to look at dynamic blocks. In this sample drawing, you can see that I have four furniture blocks, a chair, a two-seater, a three-seater, and a four-seater. Each of them are individual blocks, and I would like to combine them in a single block unit and also apply some dynamic block parameters to it. So in order to do it, I'm going to select all my four furniture pieces, and I'm going to type in the block command. In the block definition dialog, I'm going to give this block a name, for instance, dynamic furniture. And I'm going to choose to open it in the block editor. So once I'm in the block editor, this gives us access to the block authoring tool palettes with predefined parameters, actions, parameter sets, and also constraints. So in this example, I'm going to focus on the visibility parameter and the rotation parameter and the rotate action for the parameter. So first of all, I'm going to draw a reference line at my origin point. Again, we're going to delete this line later. This line is just for reference, so I can easier move my furniture pieces to the origin. So you can see that each individual block has the insertion point or the base point specified in the center of the furniture piece. You can always edit that by choosing a new base point, for example, at the corner. So I'm gonna keep it in the center point of the furniture pieces so I can easier align them. Oops. So I can easily align them and stack over each other. So you can see now that I have created the displacement point. And the very first thing what I'm going to do is to apply the visibility parameter just underneath the furniture. So I can always have access to it, doesn't matter of what furniture piece I'm going to choose later. So once I have displaced the visibility parameter, you can notice here that the visibility ribbon has become active. So I'm going to pause here for now with this parameter, and I'm going to move to the rotation parameter. Also, if you, the very first thing that you are prompted is to specify the base point. When you choose the base point, for example, at this corner of your furniture, this will determine the center of this rotation parameter or this rotation action that we're going to apply a little bit later. So in my case, I would like to keep it in the center, and I would choose also the same center point that I have chosen for my furniture blocks. So once you confirm the second displacement point, you are prompted to specify the default rotation angle or a base angle. So in this case, the rotation angle will basically determine in what angle you would like to rotate this furniture pieces. So for example, if you would choose to the 90 degree angle, it will always rotate around the 90 degrees. And in my example, I'm going to choose the 0 degrees, so I can rotate it freely 360 degrees around the axis. So once I have displaced it, I'm going to move to actions and choose the rotate action. So once you apply the rotate action, you are prompted to select the parameter you would like to apply this rotate action to. And the second prompt is to select the objects you would like to rotate. So in this case, I am going to select all the furniture pieces, and keep a note that I am also selecting the visibility parameter I placed earlier underneath the furniture. So basically, this will ensure that whenever I'm going to rotate my furniture piece, the visibility parameter is going to rotate with it. So once I'm happy with my selection, you can also exclude it from the selection by hitting the Shift key, which will basically ensure that you rotate only the furniture, but the visibility parameter will be remain static at this displacement point. So in for my needs, I'm going to include it there. So again, I just gonna grab everything and I have gonna hit enter to confirm. And now you can see that the rotate action icon is displaced just beside the rotation parameter. So we are done with the rotation parameter in action, and we're gonna return now to the visibility state. So I'm gonna activate the visibility states dialog, and you can see here I have a already initial visibility state 0, which I'm going to rename to be the chair, and I'm going to create a new one to be my two-seater. And in here you have some predefined options. So in my case, I'm gonna leave it as a visibility state, and I'm gonna apply the hidden and visible elements later. So I'm gonna repeat it with the three-seater and the four-seater. So once I'm done with my visibility states, I'm gonna change back to the chair visibility state. Or we could also use the four-seater, it really doesn't matter. The only thing that matters to us is these two options. So make visible or make invisible. So in this case, I'm in my initial chair visibility state, and I'm gonna hide everything else that I do not like to see in this visibility state. So it's basically my four-seater, my three-seater, and my two-seater. I'm gonna keep the rotation and visibility parameter visible. So once I'm done, I'm gonna confirm it with the enter key. So only the chair will remain in this visibility state, and my visibility and rotation parameters in action. So I'm gonna repeat the same with the two-seater, and I'm gonna hide this time the chair, and I'm gonna hide also the four-seater and the three-seater. So once I'm done, I'm gonna hit enter to confirm, so we can see now only the two-seater in this visibility state. And we're gonna repeat the same for the three-seater. So hide the four-seater, the chair, and the two-seater, hit enter to confirm. And last but not least, repeat that with the four-seater as well. So we are done here. So we can now freely switch between the visibility states. Also, if you would like to see a reference, you can activate this option here, which will also in each visibility state display blurry all the hidden elements. So I'm gonna undo that. And before I save the changes to my block, I go to the test environment in order to test my block and the parameters. And here I can see I still need to remove the reference line. So we're gonna return to that a little bit later. In here now we can freely choose between the different visibility states and also apply our rotation parameter. So the reference line is not being rotated because I excluded it from my selection point. But you can see whenever I'm going to rotate this chair around the axis, the visibility parameter is also moving with it. So I can freely choose between the visibility states at a comfortable place without it been getting in the way. For example, if I move it in the 90 degrees, so it would probably hide, the chair would probably hide this visibility state if I wouldn't have included it in my selection. But here I can freely choose between the different visibility states or between my different furniture blocks, and also keep freely rotating it around the axis. So once I'm happy with the tests I have done and the results I'm getting, I'm gonna close the test block environment. So I'm gonna return now to my block editor. And here we're gonna select this reference line and delete it. Once we're done, we're gonna close the block editor. And now we are prompted if we're gonna want to save the changes to our dynamic furniture block, or if we wanna discard the changes. So in my case, I'm happy with the results and I would like to save it. So now you can see that my furniture block has moved to the base point or to the origin point that I selected earlier. So in this case, I'm gonna just move it back, and I'm gonna use Control C and Control V in order to copy this block instance, and now returning back to my sketched up floor plan, I'm gonna place the chair and rotate it freely in my plan, saving me a little bit of time. And I'm gonna repeat the steps, switching between the different visibility states. So for example, if I would like to see a four-seater in this corner, I can freely rotate it, switch between the different visibility states, and choose the displacement point, which in my example is the center of the furniture piece. So in here, we're gonna use the three-seater, for example, and just displace it here. And at last, we're gonna choose the two-seater and also adjust the rotation angle of the two-seater, for example, like that. So this saves me a lot of time in order to apply different or combine different blocks into a single block unit. And also by applying the different parameters, I can freely rotate and switch between the different visibility states as I'm designing my floor plan. Also, the benefit of using it is to help you to organize your content. So for example, if you are working with tool palettes, here you can see that we have some predefined tool palettes in metric and sample tool palette blocks. So you can see this little funder icon here beside the block, which indicates that this is a dynamic block. However, those predefined blocks, they are mainly 2D blocks or isometric blocks. So in this case, I would like to reuse my block, and I'm gonna displace it in this selection of the dynamic furniture. I'm gonna also make sure that you always save the settings, save the changes in your drawing. So this drawing is basically gonna be my source for this dynamic block or my source file. And when I'm going to create new drawings, I can always simply from the tool palettes, click this block, and with all the features that I have designed, easily reuse it in other floor plans. Thank you for watching.